Now let's switch gears and follow along as we form a recording. We usually start with the membrane test, that is this pipette poking at the cell up here. The first thing we do in the amplifier control panel, the D-patch control panel here, is eliminating the offset, correcting the offset here. We have a model cell connected, switch to the bath position. That means we're simulating a 10 megaohm pipette being in the bath. And since we don't have a Faraday cage here, we see a little bit of line frequency hum here. We'll deal with that later. As we simulate approaching the cell with the pipette, we switch to seal, and that forms a seal. So we now have a seal of many gigohms and our line frequency noise on this. And what we would normally do is click auto for the electrode compensation. So we would compensate for the electrode capacitance. And the auto algorithm in many cases almost completely eliminates the pipette capacitance, the transients. And what we can do to zoom in is here expand by dragging a marquee and then expanding here. And what we could try is using the two-dimensional matrix here to compensate for the mag and the tau and touch that up a little better. Ideally, the auto compensation should have done a reasonably good job. What we probably also want to do now, first I want to auto scale here and actually zoom out a couple more times. What we also may want to do here is enable the line frequency reduction, and we just want to replace the signal. And that is a software algorithm that pretty elegantly completely eliminates the line frequency that we're picking up here because we're holding the model cell just in a room that's not shielded or anything. So let's compare that again. Let's switch that off and replacing the signal pretty much eliminates the line frequency. The next thing we will do is switch to cell because then the membrane resistance is written to the log here and then also used for the metadata. And I will zoom out on the y-axis a couple more times because we're expecting the capacitive transients to grow dramatically as we break in, which means we switch the model cell to cell mode. And here we have the larger capacitive transients. Here we have our about 500 megaohm membrane resistance with a 25-ish picofarad transient. And again, for the whole cell compensation, we just click the auto and look what happens. And almost disappears. And again, we can manually touch that up if we like. To the point where we want it. I'm not going to spend too much time here on getting that ideal, and the same for the series resistance correction. Due to the digital architecture of the compensation circuits, we can afford to do relatively much series resistance correction. 70 up to 90% should be feasible. But as I said, I'm not going to spend too much time here on trying to optimize that. But we'll just leave it as is and move on to routine data acquisition. And in order to understand that, we need to look into the data file format that Sutterpatch produces. And I'll show two slides about that.
Follow along the next episode in the series or jump to the playlist for other informative videos. Subscribe now to keep up with the latest installments.